Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope that you're all doing well. Sorry that it's taken so long to post this video. Literal life update. I am now a third year student nurse, which means dissertation, which was set last week and my head has just been blown. So most of my time I've been spent revising, writing down notes just to know what I'm gonna write this dissertation about. Alongside that, I have another assignment as well, which is like this poster assignment, and it's literally been baffling my brain what to do this topic on. So yeah, that's my little life update. So for those of you that didn't know, I am also a nail tech. So I have been a nail tech for 7 years. When I left school in 2015, I decided, yeah, I don't want to carry on with school anymore. I want to be a beautician. Best thing that I ever did. So let me tell you how I managed to build my brand Gel by Jazz. In 2015, I decided, yes, I want to go to beauty college. And I went to this amazing beauty college where I met so many people and everyone was just so nice, but I was so scared. All my friends went to do sixth form and I just never knew if I did the right thing. So in my first year of beauty school, I remember learning nails, pedicures, manicures, gel nails. I got to learn waxing. And then in my second year of beauty school, I learned how to do facial electrical, massage therapy. So I got my first job at a beauty salon when I was 17. On that job, I was day in, day out doing massages, nails, facials, waxing, you name it, I did everything. But I remember when I had my first nail client. Yes, I learned it at college, but I didn't really know what I was doing. Anyway, I got really pushed into the deep end and I did a set of nails and they literally came off this client within 2 days. God, when I tell you, I was so devastated that my boss at the time sent me on a nail course with a local beauty wholesalers. So I did that course, and from then nails had been my favorite thing to do ever. So at this salon I was doing nails all the time. Any nail client that came, that was mine. Like, I wasn't sharing. I love doing nails, I love doing designs. However, French nail client came. When I tell you, when I was painting this French, my hands was going like this, like as I was painting it, like it was just bad. So I invested in a little dummy hand that I would try and paint my own Frenches on. And over time, I think it took about a good month or so before I could perfect a French. And then I decided, right, I think I want to do this from home, because as much as I love doing it at the salon, I want to keep practicing, and you're only set in that limited time of work where you can do nails, and you're not always guaranteed nail clients every single day. So I was like, right, I want to do this from home. I started doing it on family and friends, and that's where Gelled by Jazz started. My first ever brand name was Jaceline's Nails, very cliche. God, I remember like all the clients I ended up getting was like so crazy. And then I stopped, because then I started doing an access course at university, and then that took over my life, because that's when I realized I wanted to be a nurse. I did the access course. I only did a very minimal amount of nails in that time. Then went to university, and it was only 2 years ago where I decided, actually, let's start nails again. This is where Gelled by Jazz came from. So I was always thinking of a business name, because Jaceline's Nails was just not working for me, and it just wasn't as out there as I wanted it to be. So that's where Gelled by Jazz came from. I only do gel nails, and I only do them on natural nails. At the moment on my Instagram, I am posting my nail journey, my own biab journey, until I'm on my next placement, and then these are gonna have to come off. I have absolutely loved this journey. I have met so many amazing clients and They've all kept me so busy and I'm so grateful. It's coming up to Christmas now and yeah, the books are filling up. In this video, I want to make it clear that nail techs do not gatekeep. And this video is all about everything that you need as a first time buy-up tech, first time nail tech, a first time starting your own business. Please do like, subscribe and share and let's get started. So the first thing you need as a nail tech, a good pair of gloves. You do not want to wreck your own hands when you're doing nails. I mean, dust flies everywhere. Get yourself a good pair of gloves. These are latex free. Oh, I'm holding them upside down. And I just picked pink because they're dead pretty. And these I just got off Amazon. They weren't that expensive at all. You get 100 gloves in the pack. And yeah, these are just to protect your own hands, especially if you've got your own nails on as well. There's nothing worse than doing someone's nails with a file and then filing your own gels off. You don't want that. So yes, invest in a good pair of gloves. The next thing that you want to invest in is a good nail file and a good buffer. So I'm one of those nail techs that don't use a nail drill. Now, yes, I know everyone's gonna scream at me because they're like, oh my God, you're gonna end up getting wrist injury, you're gonna end up getting hand injury. Yes, but I'm dead careful. I have only used a buffer and a file for 7 years. I haven't ever used a drill. I'm absolutely petrified of drills, but drills work for a lot of other nail techs. They just don't work for me. If you're a nail tech, comment down below what you would do with a drill. But yeah, just personally, I don't use them. So invest in a really good buffer and a really good file. This file is an NSI one. I just got this from my local beauty wholesalers. Both sides are 100 grit. I only ever really use 100 grit, especially with builder gel. I don't find that you have to really file the nail down for the gel to stick. I think you just need a really good buff. So yeah, this is the NSI one. I've used this brand for years. So yeah, this is a really good nail file. And then my buffer, I do really just get any buffer really, but this is the Halo Elite one. Again, from my local beauty wholesalers. This is a really good buffer. I find that each side really does last a long time. And yeah, when you spray sanitizer spray on it as well, it does really last and the grit really stays. So yeah, that's a really good buffer as well. Another great thing to have in your nail collection, especially for your files, buffers, your tools as well, is a really good sanitizer spray. I don't know if you can see the gel bottle sanitizer AF spray. It's amazing. It's an antibacterial tool and surface spray. It's got 24-hour protection with it as well. Absolute must in my collection. I think I've gone through 5 of these bottles already. But yeah, no, this is really good. It keeps your nail tools really protected as alongside using barbicide and stuff. But yeah, really easy, really quick to use. So definitely recommend in your nail kit. So the next thing that you should have in your nail kits or tools is a really good prep and wipe spray. This is the Salon Systems Gelux Prep and Wipe solution. It cleanses the nail plate, gets it really nice and clean and dust free for when you're starting your gel application. You want the nail to be especially clean from dust, residue and everything. So this prep and wipe solution is amazing for that. So I have 2 types of lint-free wipes. So I use the gel bottles lint-free wipes. These are the no fluff. There are 1,000 wipes in this. This is amazing. Come like this, and there are really thin wipes that you can just put your prep and wipe solution on and clean your nails with. Or I just got these off Shein. These are also lint-free wipes. These have 200 pads in them. These are a little bit different. These have little holes in them. Doesn't matter which ones you get, as long as there's no lint in them, you're absolutely fine. You don't want lint in your gel manicure. So these are amazing things to have in your kit and very essential. So in terms of cuticle work, I take my cuticle work very seriously. One thing that I really prioritize on is getting a really nice clean cuticle. So to do that, sometimes if they're really tough cuticle, I'll use the Sally Hansen Instant Cuticle Remover. This one's really good. So it's like a little gel consistency. Oh, honestly, it instantly removes your cuticles. It's incredible and it's so quick and easy to use. It works within 15 seconds. So yeah, it's a really good thing to have in your kit, especially if cuticle work is not your strong point or you find that your clients have really cuticles that you're unable to clip off. This is really good. This will make it so soft that they literally push back. And I always show my clients, like when I first put it on, how like how much cuticle they actually have and how much dead skin they have on their nails. It's really satisfying to use. So yeah, the Sally Hansen Instant Cuticle Remover. A great thing to have in your kit. On the line of cuticles, after you finished your manicure, a really nice cuticle oil is a must. You're recommending to your client, oh, aftercare advice, go home and use some cuticle oil. This one I literally just get from Amazon, the Cutio Luxury Spa Cuticle Oil in Melon and Kiwi. Now, they have loads of different scents that you can pick from. This is amazing and it literally lasts you for such a long time. It's easy to use, it's a little squeezy bottle. Yeah, really good thing to use on your nails. And it's instantly moisturizing, nourishing on the nails. And literally after a manicure, like, there's nothing better than putting cuticle oil on and it literally just finishes off the whole look. So yeah, lovely cuticle oil. On the line of cuticles, you want to get yourself a really good cuticle nipper and a good cuticle pusher. These are just mine off Amazon. These have lasted me really well, especially with regular cleaning. They're so easy to clean. This is a really good cuticle pusher and it's got a little scrapey cuticle bit on the end as well. My cuticle nip, now with regular cleaning and everything, it has like the color has worn a little bit on them, but this is that. Yeah, really good cuticle nipper and it's quite sharp as well, so you obviously be very careful, but it's really good for getting around the cuticles. Really good tool to have. So yeah, cuticle pusher and cuticle nipper. That's all the cuticle bits done. Let's move on to the gel bits. So if you follow my gel Instagram account, you know that I am a massive gel bottle fan. Absolutely love the gel bottle. I think the gel bottle is incredible. They have also just released their Hema Free range, but I'm just gonna go ahead and show you what bits I use and things that I've changed over the years. So if you're wanting to become a Biab nail tech, definitely invest in these three Biabs. These three Biabs are my most popular Biabs at the moment. Biab 19, Biab Dreamer, Biab Teddy. These are my most popular Biabs and it is more about the shade, but as a nail tech, the gel bottle's consistency is just so easy to work with. It's just so smooth. But that's the same with all the Biabs. They all have a really good hold and a really good consistency. However, I recently discovered Glossify's Natural Build, which again has an amazing hold. Now, before the gel bottle went Hema-free, I really wanted to introduce a Hema-free alternative in my collection. This is in the shade Pearl, which is now coming a fan favorite in my collection. So many people are getting Pearl. It's an amazing color and it's such a pretty color. It literally suits everyone's skin tone. It is absolutely incredible. I really enjoy their ethos. It's literally Hema free. It's an absolutely amazing gel to have, especially the Glossify is a cheaper alternative to the gel bottle. The gel bottle can be quite pricey, so if you want something a little bit more affordable, definitely get Glossify. But these two are absolutely popular. It's Nude and Pearl. So yeah, if you're looking for a Hema free alternative which is cheaper, definitely go with the Glossify Natural Builds. Then undoubtedly the gel bottle for their colors. their colour ranges, I think they have like over 1,000 colours in their colour range. This one is Bluefin. It's such a cute blue. But as you can see, I have loads of colours. Yeah, absolutely love the gel bottle colours. I always get them on offer at Christmas. Always ask for them as Christmas presents. But these are amazing. They are so pigmented. They are so beautiful. They apply on like silk. They are just so amazing. The colors are incredible. But then again, if you want a cheaper alternative, because yes, these can be quite expensive, Glossify also do colors as well. So yeah, both are amazing, but I am such a gel bottle color girl. Then you're probably thinking, oh my god, Jazz, you have all these colors, where do you put them all? How do you advertise? I have the little gel bottle like display book. It's incredible. I can literally ping these off, try them on my clients. I said I had loads of colors, but according to this I have nothing. But this book literally fills up 120 colors that are in your collection now. But yeah, it's a great way of displaying all your colors to your customers. You can literally have it out on the table for them to look at, and it's just such an easy way to like look at colors. For example, it literally pings off. You know, you can literally try on whatever color you want, which is just so nice and yeah, really easy. I thought I'd also add in what my favorite dark shade and what my favorite light shade from the gel bottle is. So my favorite all-time dark shade is Arabian Nights. It is so pretty. I've used this on so many clients this autumn. A beautiful, beautiful dark red color. And then my favorite light shade is Gloss by the gel bottle. Beautiful light pink. And it goes on quite sheer, which I really like because it's good for those clients that just want to add a touch of pink to their color, their nails. So if you've got quite nude nails and you just want to add that little bit extra. As I mentioned at the start of the video, I only do natural nails, but only recently the gel bottle came out with Proform. I have been obsessed with Proform. So I brought the whole Proform range. It came with a brush, it came with I believe 6 colours, it came with the slip and sculpt, and then this I brought separately, but it's the nail forms. I don't know if everyone heard of the concept of polygel a couple of years ago. Well, this is similar to polygel, or it is polygel. It just works so beautifully. It literally sculpts on your nails like so effortlessly. Again, just so easy to use, just so beautiful to use as well. So really recommend these if you're wanting to do gel extensions as an alternative or as an additional service. Oh, as a nail tech, you don't always do gel manicures. Sometimes a client will come in and just say, can I have a manicure, a soak off, and then can I just have a strengthener on top? Always make sure you have a strengthener on hand. I use the Sally Hansen Maximum Growth Strengthener. This one, while I was in between hospital shifts, I'd put this on my nails, obviously take them off when I'm at the hospital. And this would keep my nails really strong for the days that I was off. My nails got quite damaged while I was at the hospital, so just having this on helped my nails grow out really nicely and prepare them for my biab journey. This is a really good thing to have in your kit. It's just a great alternative. Maximize growth on their nails and keep them really nice and protected. Yeah, the Sally Hansen Maximum Growth is a really good thing to have in your kit. Just, yeah, for them clients that say, I just want a manicure. Finally, you've completed your gel manicure now. You've applied your cuticle oil. You're then gonna want a really good cream and a really good hand mask. Hand mask is optional. I have this Molton Brown cream. A beautiful client of mine works for Molton Brown and asked if I wanted one. So yeah, an absolutely amazing cream. All my clients rave about this when it's on their hands. They say how nice it smells, and honestly it does, it smells incredible. It's so nourishing, it keeps your hands so nice and soft. Yeah, this one's in the scent Rhubarb and Rose. No, I am so grateful to have clients that work for such amazing companies that do bring me stuff to try out. This one, definitely my favorite. But yeah, just a really good hand moisturizer, nothing too expensive. But also you want to add that scent of luxury to your nail clients' hands. So yeah. And then optionally, I also use a hand mask. This is the peachy hand mask. Smells quite oaty as well. This one keeps my client's hands so nourished and so moisturized. I only optionally put this on sometimes, but it just adds that extra pizzazz to your business. And you know, for bringing clients back, the aftercare is incredible. So yeah, if you enjoyed that video, please like, subscribe and press that post notification button for more videos from me. I will promise I will try and be a bit more consistent, because I really do enjoy YouTube. I absolutely love it. And yeah, comment if you're a nail tech, what your essentials are, and share what you love using as a nail tech, what your go-to brands are. Everything that I've got might not work on you, however, they're really good brands to use. And yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.